Our final speaker is Masako Fukutani, who will be presenting Haruki, Murakami, metaphor of digging a well as an intense self-exploration.
Hi, so my topic is Haruki, Murakami, metaphor of digging a well as an intense self-exploration. So before proceeding to my actual presentation, I would like to explain who Murakami is, actually. And he's a globally renowned Japanese novelist, and he immediately got so much attention once he started writing novels at the age 29. And he's known for his magical realism-like style. And so, for example, in the Wonderbird Chronicle, which I'm going to talk about more in this presentation, functions as a gateway to another world, but the world outside the well is just like ours. So there's a coexistence between realistic elements and also fantasy elements. So this is actually my presentation. So my capstone is on a well as a gateway to another world while in dream. And these are three main works that I worked on throughout my capstone. And one is The Wind Up Bird Chronicle by Haruki Murakami, and another one is Alice's Adventures in Wonderland by Lewis Carroll. And the last one is The Sheepman's Christmas, which is not available in English. And so the original title is called Hitsuji Otoko no Christmas in Japanese. And so I translated whenever I had to cite in my capstone. So there's a similar pattern observed in all of these three works. And in the Wonderbird Chronicle, the protagonist goes inside and sleeps inside a well, and he experiences another world while in dream, and he repeats the same thing. He comes out of the well, but he eventually comes back to inside a well and sleeps there and experiences another world again. So in Alice's Adventures in Wonderland, as you may know, Alice falls inside a rabbit hole, she experiences another world, and she wakes up at the end of the story. And the same thing happens to The Sheepman's Christmas. The protagonist falls inside a deep hole and he experiences another world, and he wakes up at the end of the story. So what is this concept of a well as a gateway to another world? To Murakami in particular, I'm not going to talk about Lewis Carroll in this presentation because of the time constraint, but Murakami says in one of the interviews that he took, he says, I believe that the motif of a well entails the primary metaphor for digging the ground beneath one's own feet or one's own consciousness deeper and deeper. So here I suspect that he uses this metaphor of a well as an intense and profound self-exploration. So I like to also introduce the metaphor of human individual as a two-story house that he often talks about, especially after he wrote the Wonderbird Chronicle in several interviews. So according to him, on the first floor of yourself, so human individual is a two-story house. So on the first floor, you talk or eat or watch TVs with your friends and family, so it's kind of a public space within yourself. And on the second floor, excuse my language. So on the second floor, you have your private private room, and you listen to music, and you read, and you know, you have your own time and space for yourself. And so there is, according to Murakami, there is a basement floor, which is a special place where various stuff is stored. Although you do not usually use the stuff, you sometimes go down there and just let time slip by. What I believe here, however, is that there is another floor underneath. So before going to talk about the basement floor, according to him, this basement floor is where we store traumatic experiences or ego, and also our own opinions that we don't usually share. So we can consciously go down to this basement floor, but there's another sub-basement floor, and so you cannot easily go into the sub-basement room because the door is specially designed not to be found easily. Some people may end their life without entering the room at all. If you enter by some chance, you will find yourself in the darkness. You go into the darkness and experience something you can never see in other rooms upstairs. So also on another occasion, he said what welcomes you in this basement floor is complete darkness and inside metaphysical signs, ideas, and symbols. These kind of things welcome you like one after another. So like he says, this basement floor is some kind of a guest out of subconscious world. So and also he says, you have to leave the sub-basement to go back to reality. And he even says that it's just like a dream. So like it kind of makes sense because you have to wake up to go back to reality. You can't sleep forever. And you have to wake up to come back to reality. And this metaphor of a two-story house and, well, connects really strongly, I think, and also in fictional works of Murakami as well. And here, I would like to talk about paradox of self-exploration that Murakami talks about. And he says the act of digging or staying inside a well is an extremely solitary thing to do. However, at the same time, I feel that we can reach some sort of common understanding with others, though paradoxically as a result of thoroughly deepening solitude. So what he says here, if I put it super simply, there's two wells, and these two wells are, you know, seemingly distant from each other, but if you explore yourself really intensely, then you can somehow reach understanding of others. And so this concept, so what's interesting here about this is that both in Wonderbird Chronicle and The Sheepman's Christmas by Murakami, the protagonists discover something that they never knew about someone else at the end of the story after experiencing the other world inside a well. So after they come back from the other world, then they discover something else. So I think this represents the understanding of others that they reach in the story. And this concept also appears in the latest novel of Murakami, Kirin Commendatore, just published in February this year. The protagonist, a professional painter, experiences another world called the world of metaphor while in dream inside a mysterious hall. After his exploration of the other world at the end of the story, the protagonist feels a change within himself and reflects, the power of believing resides within me. No matter how narrow and dark the place I may be stuck in, or no matter how rough the wilderness I might be placed in, I can forthrightly believe that there is always something that can guide me to somewhere. So even though this protagonist states this in a confident manner, what he says here is super ambiguous and abstract. Yet, these ambiguity and abstractness do not derive from an irresponsibly optimistic observation of his life, but from a profound self-exploratory process through the creative activity of painting and the exploration of the other world. Although no one would understand what he experienced inside a hall as reality because the world of metaphor is full of fantasy elements, this is his declaration that he will be responsibly believing his own life because that's what he actually experienced. So lastly, I would like to talk about why this is solely based on my interpretation, but I would like to talk about why Murakami chose well or hall in particular instead of anything else. So the mysteriousness of the invisibility and anonymity of the bottom of the deep hole is as if a metaphor for our own life. Most of the time, our attention is directed toward the invisible past and future. We have to rely on our unreliable memory of the past and speculate and calculate ahead of the uncertain future. In addition, we live under pressure of anonymous factors called social norms, logic, and rationality. Once the protagonists reach the bottom, however, what welcomes them is another world with full of illogical fantasy elements. Yet, they sincerely face the other world and explore the other world. So, in other words, they face themselves sincerely. And and they reach the understanding of something outside the world in their reality eventually. Thus, if you want to understand others, I think Murakami teaches us that we should first sincerely and responsibly face our own life extremely deeply, because that can somehow lead you to understanding of someone else. Thank you.